Hello, space fans, and welcome to another edition of Space Fan News. This week, ESA's Philae lander, a part of the Rosetta mission to Comet 67P, has been found. Also, the Rosetta spacecraft orbiting said comet will smash into it on September 30th, and SpaceX announces that it is ready to resume launches later this year. On September 5th, the European Space Agency announced that the Philae lander, a part of the Rosetta mission to Comet 67P, Churyumov-Gerasimenko, announced that they have found the lander that had bounced and lost contact with it on November 12, 2014. With less than a month left in the Rosetta mission, members of the team were able to get these really great detailed images using the onboard OSIRIS narrow-angle camera as the orbiter came within 2.7 kilometers of the surface of the comet. The images clearly show the main body of the lander along with two of its three legs. These images also show the orientation of the lander on its side, wedged into a dark crevice on the comet. Now, in case you don't know what happened, on November 12, 2014, the Philae lander was supposed to touch down on the comet's surface and use two harpoon-like spears to grab onto the surface once it arrived. Now, something went wrong, though. Maybe the harpoons fired too soon, or for whatever reason, that caused the lander to bounce. It then flew for 2 hours after it bounced, and then came to rest here, in a location called Abydos, on the comet's smaller lobe. So here's where it sat, and after that, the lander worked for 3 days, until the primary battery was drained, and the lander then went into hibernation. Now, looking at this, it's easy to see why establishing communications was so hard, and why the batteries died lying in that dark crevice. With no sunlight to recharge the batteries, it was game over until just last June and into July of this year, as the comet came closer to the sun and more power became available and communication was established very briefly. After that, the lander was silent forever, but they still wanted to see if they could find where the heck the lander was. Since the mission was ending this month, people were starting to worry that the lander would be lost forever. So these images came as a big sigh of relief. Now that they know where the lander is, as well as its orientation, astronomers can make better sense of the data that Philae was able to gather during the 3 days while it was working. Now, these images put what scientists call ground truth, confirmation to the lander's fate. Ground truth just means that they've got actual observations. They can see it with their own eyes instead of using models or simulations based on the best data available. So everyone at ESA working on the Rosetta mission is thrilled to have found the lander during the final month of the mission because, well, that brings me to my second story for this week. September 30th marks the final days of the Rosetta mission because on that day, just a couple of weeks from now, mission planners are going to put the spacecraft, which is currently in elliptical orbits, which since August 9th have been bringing the Rosetta orbiter progressively closer to the comet's surface. And on its closest and final flyby, which is scheduled for September 24th, the orbiter may get as close as 1 kilometer above the surface. Closer than it has ever been. And next, after this final approach, a short series of maneuvers will be executed that are designed to line up Rosetta with the target impact site. These will take several days to complete as it transfers from being in an elliptical orbit and onto a trajectory that will eventually take it to the comet's surface on September 30th. And that should be really cool to watch. So what's going to happen is they're going to get the spacecraft into position to hit the comet about 20 kilometers above the surface. Then put it in a free fall. And the instruments on board will collect data during its descent and return it to Earth just before it hits. They expect the impact to occur within 20 minutes of 10:40 universal time. Now, they can't get an exact time because they won't be sure of the exact trajectory until the spacecraft gets into position. Rosetta is already starting to feel the effects of gravity of the comet as it gets closer, and taking into account the 40-minute signal delay between Rosetta and Earth, they expect to know sometime within 20 minutes of 10:40 UT that it hit. So here's how they expect to know precisely when Rosetta hits the comet. This is data from a spectrum analyzer showing the signal received by ground stations from Rosetta spacecraft. When that peak that you see on the right goes away and looks like the left, the spacecraft is presumed dead and has hit the comet. It's going to hit in a region called Ma'at, on the smaller of the two lobes of the comet. It is home to several active pits more than 100 meters in diameter and 50 to 60 meters deep, and it's also where a number of the comet's dust jets originate. So you may be wondering, how fast will it be going when it hits? The current predictions are that it will be going 90 centimeters per second, or about 2 miles per hour. They expect the impact will damage the solar panels and other appendages on the spacecraft, and the energy dissipated from this will probably keep any bouncing that the spacecraft does from exceeding the escape velocity of the comet, preventing it from returning to orbit around it. So on a side note, while we're also talking about the Philae lander, the final trajectory of Rosetta will be on the opposite side of the comet that the Philae lander is currently resting on, so it won't be able to see the orbiter as it plunges to the surface, which is really kind of too bad. That'd be awesome to see, too. It's incredible to think that it took Rosetta 10 years to get to Comet 67P. It studied it for 2 years, and now it's going to die. These final sets of science operations should culminate in a better understanding of comet structure, composition, behavior, and properties of comets in our solar system. So well done, Rosetta team. I'll let you know how it went in early October once the data are back. Finally, in a follow-up to the last SFN I did, where I told you about the explosion that rocked Launch Complex 40 at Cape Canaveral, SpaceX announced this week that it will try to resume launches this November from Launch Pad 39A. So this is the second of two launch pads that SpaceX has available in Florida. And while the damage to Launch Complex 40 is extensive, apparently, and it may take up to a year to repair, Pad 39A will be available in November to continue launches. Now, all of this is coming as SpaceX is still investigating the root cause of the September 1st explosion. And many are wondering if this is just wishful thinking on their part. But they are targeting November as the time to get back to business. And I will let you know. Well, that's it for this week, space fans. Thanks so much to all the SFN Patreon patrons whose support makes these episodes possible. Thank all of you for watching. And as always,